Hello everyone, we are going to discuss in this chapter the social responsibility of business. In this chapter we will discuss about the social responsibility of business, responsibility to shareholders, responsibility to employees, responsibility to consumers. There are these three most important factors of social responsibility of business. So starting with the social, what is the social responsibility of business? Social responsibility of business implies the obligation of the management of business enterprise to protect the interest of the society. According to the concept of social responsibility, the objective of managers for taking business decisions is not merely to maximize profits of shareholders, but also to serve and protect the interest of other members of society, such as workers, consumers, and the community as a whole. The World Council for Sustainable Development, in its publication Making Good Business Sense by Lord Hall and Richard Burns, used the following definitions. Corporate social responsibility is the continuing commitment by business to behave ethically and contribute to economic development while improving the quality of life of the workforce and their families as well as of the local community and society at large. The same report gave some evidence of the different perceptions of what this should mean from a number of different societies across the world. Definition as different as CSR is about capacity building for suitable livelihoods. It respects cultural difference and finds the business opportunities in building the skills of employees, the community, and the government from the India through a corporate social responsibility is about business giving back to society from the other countries. Traditionally, in the United States, corporate social responsibility has been defined much more in terms of philanthropic model. Companies like profit unhindered except by fulfilling their duty to pay taxes, then they donate a certain share of their profit to charitable cause. It is seen as tainting the act for the company to receive any benefit from the gift. Thus, such a committee on companies and MRTP acts appointed by the government of India states, in the development of corporate ethics, we have reached a stage where the question of social responsibility of business to the community can no longer be scoffed at or taken lightly. In the environment of modern corporate economic development, the corporate sector no longer functions in isolation. If the plea of the companies that they are performing a social purpose is to be accepted, it can only be judged by the test of social responsiveness shown to the needs of the society. But in today's world, the interest of other stakeholders, community, and environment must be protected and prompted. Social responsibility of business enterprise to the various stakeholders and society in general is considered to be the result of a social responsible business. So responsibility of business enterprise towards stakeholders and society in general contract is a set of rules that defines the agreed interrelationship between various elements of a society. The social contract often involves a quid pro quo. For example, something given in exchange for another. Quid pro quo is a French word which means something given in exchange for another. In the social contract, one party to the contract gives something and expects a certain thing or behavior pattern from the other. In the present context, the social contract is concerned with the relationship of a business enterprise with various stakeholders such as shareholders, employee, consumer, government, and society in general. The business enterprise happened to have resource because society consisting of various stakeholders has given them this right, and therefore it expects from them to use them for serving the interest of all of them. Though all stakeholders, including the society in general, are affected by the business activities of a corporate enterprise, managers may not acknowledge responsibility to them. Social responsibility of business implies that corporate managers must promote the interest of all stakeholders, not merely of shareholders who happen to be the so-called owners of the business enterprise. Responsibility of shareholders. So we are going to discuss about the one by one responsibility to shareholders, responsibility to employees, and responsibility to the consumers. So we will start with responsibility to shareholders. In the context of good corporate governance, a corporate enterprise must recognize the rights of shareholders and protect their interests. It should respect shareholders' right to information and respect their right to submit proposals, to vote, and to ask questions at the annual general body meeting. The corporate enterprise should observe the best code of conduct in its dealings with the shareholders. However, the corporate board and management try to increase profit or shareholders' value, but in pursuing this objective, they should protect the interest of employees, consumers, and other stakeholders. Its special responsibility is that in its effort to increase profits or shareholders' value, it should not pull out the environment. Responsibility to employees. The success of a business enterprise depends to a large extent on the morale of its employees. Employees make valuable contribution to the activities of a business organization. The corporate enterprise should have good and fair employment practices and industrial relations to enhance its productivity. It must recognize the rights of workers or employees to freedom of association and free collective bargaining. Besides, it should not discriminate between various employees. The most important responsibility of a corporate enterprise towards employees is the payment of their wages to them and provide healthy and good working conditions. The business enterprise should recognize the need for providing essential labor welfare activities to their employees. Especially, they should take care of women workers. Besides, the enterprise should make arrangements for proper training and education of the workers to enhance their skills. However, it may be noted that very few companies in India follow many of the above good practices. While the captains of Indian industries generally complain about low productivity of their employees, little has been done to address their problem. Ajit Nivard Kavral, well-known corporate social responsibility activist, rightly writes, "It should perhaps be realized that corporations can only be as effective and efficient as its employees, and therefore steps should be taken to implement such reforms in a proactive manner. Rather than merely attempting to comply with many labor laws that prevails in the country. This is probably one era where good governance practice could make a significant impact on the country's business environment." Now, responsibility to consumers. Some economists think that consumer is king, who direct the business enterprise to produce goods and services to satisfy its wants. However, in the modern times, this may not be strictly true, but the companies must acknowledge their responsibilities to protect their interest in undertaking their productive activities. Invoking the notion of social contract, the management expert Peter Drucker observes, The customer is the foundation of business and keeps it in existence. He alone gives employment to meet the wants and needs of a consumer. The society entrusts wealth producing resources to the business enterprise. In view of above, the business enterprise should recognize the rights of consumers and understand their needs and wants and produce goods or services accordingly. There are some responsibilities of business enterprise to consumers which can be mentioned here. The important responsibilities are, number one, they should supply goods or service to the consumers at reasonable price and do not try to exploit them by forming cartels. This is more relevant in case of business enterprise producing essential goods such as life-saving drugs, vegetable oils, and essential services such as electricity supply and telephone services. They should not supply to the consumers shoddy and unsafe products which may do harm to them. They should provide the consumers the required after-sale service. They should not misinform the consumers through inappropriate and misleading advertisements. They should make arrangements for proper distribution system of their products so as to ensure the black marketing and profiteering by traders do not occur. And the last, they should acknowledge the rights of consumers to be heard and take necessary measures to redress their genuine grievances.